All right. Yep, we should be live now. Welcome everyone to the first match of the Nordic 4-Digit Catch Cup. This is the round of 24, the first round here, obviously. We have the Cuba X versus Aflatoppers from Sweden and from Iceland. I'm Ash Ketchum, the host of the tournament, and I'm joined by Jurgen, or 1794766, or user ID, whatever you want to call him. How are you doing?
Thank you so much for having me. Yeah, I'm a good time. Really looking forward to get this thing started and see some 4-digit action.
Oh yeah. This is obviously the first edition of the Nordic 4-digit Catch Cup. We obviously did the Nordic Catch Cup before, and that was a lot of fun and a lot of excitement there. But this time we wanted to give back to the community a little bit for the, you know, newer or somewhat inexperienced players, so that they could have a chance and have a chance at a more competitive stage for themselves. So I'm really excited to see how things turn out, and I'm really excited just for this tournament in general. Yeah,
it'll be good. Like, I think it will be motivational for the players, especially because they couldn't get that far in a previous tournament. So it'll be nice to see maybe some of them can get like top 8, and being like 4-digit, that could be a really big boost to confidence, I think.
Oh yeah, absolutely. I mean, hopefully that's what these players get out of this whole experience, you know, just wanting to play more and keep improving in this game. That's kind of the goal here for me, at least, as a host.
Oh, absolutely.
Just get inspired. Anyway. So, the players that we have, obviously, the Cuba X with seed 12 versus Aflatoppur with seed 21 from Iceland, by the way, one of the three Icelandic players in this tournament. Yes, indeed. If you look at the seedings overall, I mean, the Cuba X is obviously a higher seed and is perhaps favored, but with these early rounds, you never know what could happen. You never know. I still think, I don't know, it's gonna be tough. Aflatoppur obviously only ranked 9,000, just grinded to get into this tournament and just barely made it, so...
Oh yeah, it was the last entry, right?
Okay. We're getting a little technical problem here, guys. We don't have access to the chat just yet, so... All right, we're getting it fixed. Sorry about this, guys. Anyway, Jurgen.
Yeah.
I want to ask you some questions about this tournament and what's going to happen. Do you have any predictions on... Maybe this is too hot of a take or too hot of a question here, but do you have any predictions on who's going to win the tournament?
The grand finals?
The grand finals, yeah.
Oh, I don't know. I see seed 3 Lanky is definitely up there. It's been I'm sort of a bit of family from him. Like, we've been friends ever since he started in 2013. And I know he's way better than his rank actually says. Also Moppen is great. Hypnospiro maybe.
Nice, yeah. Obviously.
There's a lot of new names here that I haven't really seen that much. So it's easy for me to choose someone I have seen. Also, maybe also top seed. Wouldn't be dangerous on high AR stuff, it seems.
And I mean, Lanky, obviously a veteran of the game from Norway. I mean, they've even played in Cash World Cups before, right?
Oh yeah. Absolutely. Almost every year, I think.
Exactly, so... That's definitely a scary, experienced player to go up against in a tournament like this. Mm-hmm. One player I want to point out is an Apple 7 from Latvia. So,
Oh, yeah.
Their rank, maybe 3,500 or whatever it is, but don't let that fool you, because I believe they only play Spotlights, which is, you know, not score V1. They don't submit those scores. But when they play in tournaments, they, like, are capable of beating 3 digits, even. Like, their skill is way, way above 3,500, and if you look at the qualifier stats, second seed just behind Austin by like 0.1 average rank.
Yeah. That's
Yep, we should be back now. Hidden 3 from Apple Topic, correct?
All right.
Below your hidden map.
And a convert.
And a convert. That is true. That is true. A little bit of green. A bit of green on the screen.
Yeah, I would definitely say that it's a good pick from Apple Topper.
The hidden three? Yeah. If you look at qualifier results, actually, the mod that Apple Topper actually did pretty well on was hidden compared to his other results. Which is rare to see in like a really new player like him, like ranked 9,000. They don't usually play hidden or are able to play hidden that well. But yeah, it's interesting. I guess his standard experience, obviously a tournament player in standard, is able to help him there with the reading or something.
Some people just have it too. Maybe it's just one of them.
That's true. By the way, Cosmit, streamer, we're still just seeing green right now. Yes. Oh, okay. There we go. There we go. Now we're. It's okay. I think we already said it was green, but that's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Anyway, we now actually see the gameplay. So as you can see right there, the Q-Bag's leading by about 20,000, slightly points at the beginning here.
With the higher combo too. Something increased.
Those misses were early on though, so.
Yeah.
Anything. Still doable. Apple Topper finds a miss there though. That's gonna increase the lead for the Q-Bags there. Another one.
I'm wondering if they're having nerves, both of them.
I think surely they both have nerves here. I mean, especially being four digits.
Yeah. And live on Twitch as well. Can you believe it?
Live on Twitch, it's the first match of the tournament.
Mm-hmm. It's gotta be a scary experience.
Yeah, it looks like the Q-Bags is actually able to get a little bit of combo here now after those early misses in the beginning. Maybe they were just nerve misses. Apple Topper, a little combo every now and then, but finds misses in between.
Q-Bags just a little bit more consistent.
Are you looking like that right now? And, yeah, ever since those misses in the beginning, he's been holding that full combo.
Yeah. But let's see if he can hold the combo after the spinner here. It's going to be a few tricky jumps, if I remember correctly.
It's a big lead for the Q-Bags here at the break. Apple Turper clearly sees that, as you can see by those dashes and wiggles with the catcher.
And the bullets actually did the jump before. It's not bad.
Fair play. It looks like the Q-Bags actually has practiced the pool a little bit here. Looking comfortable on this lower hidden pick. Topper building up combo. Honestly, like for a rank 9,000 player, like this is not a bad performance at all.
Not bad. It started 12 days ago. It's very strong.
Well, 12 days ago?
I think so. That's when he started grinding the PP, anyway.
Oh, yeah. Well, okay. 12 days ago or something, he was ranked 14,000. Yeah, that's correct.
Yeah.
Q-Bags actually finds a miss there, but it's too late.
It's too late.
So, it's definitely going to be the first point for the Q-Bags here, and a break point at that. Unfortunately for Apple Topper, not able to hold combo consistently. And whereas the Q-Bags got that one massive combo after the beginning.
Q-Bags was too strong on this map.
Too strong indeed, and there you see it, 2 misses, 214. And I mean, just the max combo difference shows the difference in consistency here.
Absolutely.
And that's going to be... Yeah, go on. You were going to say?
It was an Apple Topper's pick too.
Oh yeah, yeah, it was. It's a break point.
I really hope it's not going to be a sweep.
It would be unfortunate, especially, you know, as an Icelandic person myself. I really don't want that to happen. I hope Apple Topper can regain some composure here and not get put down too much by this.
Great thing for me, I can't be biased.
That is true. Being a Norwegian here.
I'm just hoping for a tiebreaker, as every commentator ever wants in every match.
Oh yeah, indeed. A tiebreaker in the round 24 would actually be awesome to see. Also, we have a banger tiebreaker this week.
Oh yeah, Porter Robinson.
Porter Robinson. That would be very intense.
Kubex is, I think he's been playing since 2014. I'm not sure how much he's played in catch, but Real Strong is a good choice to pick hit Hard Rock against someone who's new to the game mode, I think.
Definitely, yeah. I think Hard Rock, it's interesting though, because the Kubex banned Hard Rock 2, I believe, but decides to pick the Comrade Hard Rock 3. This one isn't even AR10. So perhaps it could also be like all right for both players here, because it's not like AR10, it's just the circle size that's kind of tricky on this one. And the Comrade patterns, mm-hmm. obviously.
Probably going to be the Comrade patterns. Or, to be fair, Epitoper hasn't played enough to like properly see the difference. I don't think, anyway.
Yeah, maybe not. Maybe not, but you still have those, like, I don't know, random edge dashes sometimes in Comrades deck. Even if you haven't played that much specifics or Comrades, it's going to be hard to differentiate between them when you're reading.
Absolutely.
Looking at the qualifier stats, the Kubex actually got 7th place on Nomad 2 with a Convert, but 20th on Nomad 1. So it seems like the Kubex is actually better at Converts than specifics overall, if you just look at that.
And Nomad 3 was banned, so this is like the next Convert on the list, I guess.
Indeed. Appletorp already finding some early misses there. The Kubex holding that full combo still. Lag drops though.
It's playing with hidden, you gotta expect it.
Yeah, as you can see there on Appletorp's platter movement, you can see the high AR is kind of hard to get used to and adjust to, especially being rank 9000. I mean, this is not where you usually play when you open up the game.
Oh no, definitely not.
Kubex still holding the full combo though.
That's impressive. Oh, another miss by Epler.
Yeah, I mean, it seems like he's able to, like, hit the patterns, like, all of them, I'd say, but it's just a matter of consistency, as you can see there, just a couple of weird platter movements, but actually, the Kubex finds misses there as well, drops the full combo. A couple more misses there, as Epletorper now has actually the combo advantage for the first time in the match, but so far, the advantage is still in the Kubex's favor by quite a bit.
The combo difference isn't big enough either, I don't think. Oh my god. It can happen. He might actually get the point.
Well, he's going to have to hope for more misses, I think, because the lead was already so big to begin with. And Appletipper also has to hold here. He has to hope for more misses, that's for sure.
Yeah, but it's going the right way, though. But one more miss from Kubex would be very nice for Appletipper right now.
I think it's too late. I think the Kubex is going to take it. Albeit pretty close, you could say.
Yeah. That was a good game. That was a good match.
Definitely. Only about, 74,000 points difference. And only 4 misses between them. So actually, yeah, I mean, Appletober could have potentially gotten a point there if things would have gone another way.
Oh, yeah. This is giving me some hope for Appletopper. I kind of want to root for him now.
Well, hold on. You're a commentator, so...
sorry.
Wait, hold on. Let's see.
I don't root for anyone, but it would be a nice story, though.
Yes. No, sorry. I had to just do something real quick there, but... Alright, we're back now, sorry. Now, obviously, Appletorp cannot pick hidden again. That's out of the question. I wonder what he would go for here.
That's a good question. Possibly Nomad 1?
Yeah, potentially. If you look at the Kubex's qualifier scores, Appletorp actually, I believe, beat the Kubex in Nomad 1.
He definitely did. And we're seeing the Kubex use hidden a lot, so characters, like, he might be a hidden player. He might not like playing Nomad.
That is true. DT2 is the pick, though.
Ooh, that's scary.
It is quite scary, obviously, it being a specific. So, could potentially be a little bit tricky for the Cubex based on what we know so far on the converts. I don't know. Maybe he's also good at DT specifics. But FLTuffer is willing to pick DT2 here. Trying to maybe catch an opening or something.
I think it's a dangerous pick. From FLTuffer, because this song, at least, it's very hard to read where the notes are in, like, the rhythm.
Oh yeah, oh, but we already see
the game out for me.
Oh yeah, it's gonna, oh yeah. Kind of tricky to adjust to the double time catcher movement, I guess.
I've been playing for 11 years, I still don't know how to do it, so.
Yeah, it looks like, it's like it's getting a little bit better as the map goes on, but that start was a little bit all over the place there for FLTuffer, but now the Cubex only got that one miss. And already a quarter of the map over. FLTuffer still finding misses. Yeah, the Cubex comboing this quite comfortably. And FLTuffer finding misses. Yeah, that's it's already a really huge difference there.
So far, a very solid round from the Cubex.
Oh yeah, he's been playing well. That's another miss there though, but 200k point difference it was, I believe, so it's gonna be tough, especially as FLTuffer finds more misses now, and the map is so short as well. Yeah, the Cubex actually keeps finding misses, but if FLTuffer continues to find misses as well, it's not gonna be doable, I think. Last quarter of the map.
Needs to have to see the rest of this and hope for some big misses from Cuba. I just called him Cuba. I meant Cuba.
Oh, is it? Is it not Cuba? Oh, it could be Cuba? Or is it Cuba? Why not Cuba?
Why not? Oh, I don't know. It could be Cuba's. Cuba's.
Oh, so Cuba. Okay. Thank you, Cosmet. That's my bad then. But yeah, there you have it. Another breakpoint. Cubex with only 4 misses, FLTuffer 23 misses, struggling a little bit on that DT platter control.
Definitely not looking too good for Team Iceland here.
Team Iceland. Yeah, it's looking a little bit bleak from these picks so far. I think Hard Rock 3 was close. It could have gone one way or another, but so far, it's the bleak, I have to admit. Now, Hidden 2 is the pick, though.
Ginky, huh?
Hidden 2. Actually, this is, I think, AR 8.8. So, high AR, low AR. I mean, it's not high AR, and it's not, like, low enough to be low AR. It's, like, just barely below AR 9, but I would still count it as low AR, to be honest.
Well, it's because you're a double time and harder player.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah. For 4 digits, who don't play a lot of hard work, this is just normal AR.
8.8?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, you're probably right. But with hidden, it's still a little bit tricky. And this map,
it's a bit tricky.
This map has some sliders, a lot of slider ticks that could be easily dropped, a lot of ACK to be dropped. Yeah, speaking of misses, FLTuffer already finding some misses here at the beginning. A little bit shaky on the start.
Yeah, it's been shaky on all starts, I think. It sort of picks themselves up like halfway through the maps.
Yeah, at the start of the maps, it seems like he's just, I don't know, getting adjusted to it again, I guess. I mean, obviously, they're coming off of DT now onto AR 8.8 hidden.
Oh, that's the worst.
So that could also, yeah, definitely be a factor now. Cubex still holding the full combo to the first quarter. And FLTuffer having found a couple of misses. About 100,000 point difference.
Yeah. it's definitely going to be a tough match for Eppletopper against a veteran Kuba.
When he's playing like this, for sure, yeah. Kazmit, we don't see the score on the stream plan, by the way. I just noticed that. Eppletopper has actually built up quite a solid combo now.
Yeah.
But the Kuba X, that full combo, I mean.
SS.
That SS, in fact, yeah. Last quarter of the map now. Score difference is so big. I don't, even if the Kuba X finds a couple of misses here, I think it's going to be too late, I think. It's kind of sad because Eppletopper built up such a good combo after he finally found his rhythm.
Yeah, every time there's a spinner, I'm just so amazed at Eppletopper for actually almost max spinning every time.
Oh, is he?
Yeah, or at least picking the right paths all the time is impressive.
That's that gamer instinct, you could say.
I suppose so.
Yeah, like, there's
no way you could build that sort of knowledge from playing standard, so.
Yeah, exactly. It must be just some instinctual reaction. What's that?
No.
It wasn't. Hard Rock 2 was banned and Nomad 3 was banned. This wasn't banned. Oh, okay. We're fine, though. This is not banned. but yeah, I mean, Austin, worth noting that, like you just said, how was Eppletopper only 9k? He got 865,000 on Hidden 2. Yeah, it's up to 5, yes.
Ooh. Don't watch Eppletopper get 4 in a row.
Yeah, imagine that. The reverse sweep. It's just, It's looking bleak.
It is. It's a shame, too. At least there's another round. There's a brackets, it's another chance.
Yeah, indeed. And obviously, this being the round 24 system, if you win this one, you're not guaranteed top 16, because if you lose your round of 16 match, you go into a loser's bracket with someone who lost a round of 24 match. So even if you lose this one, so to speak, you're still going to be facing someone potentially who won their round 24 match in the loser's bracket. I don't know if that makes sense to anyone, but if you look at the challenge bracket, it'll make sense, trust me. Nomad 1 is actually the pick.
Ooh,
and this is the custom map that we have this round from BlackBN. Shout out to BlackBN for making this awesome map for us. Now, I think this is a good pick, actually. I think this is a good pick because if you look at the qualifiers, Eppletopper was 17th on Nomad 1. The Kuba X was 20th.
Ooh. That's looking good for our boy. I mean, for Eppletopper.
For the boy.
I'm speaking strictly as like
you're speaking generally.
I know the sport, you know.
Exactly. Yeah, actually, already an early miss from the Kuba X here. And you could see in chat that he wasn't feeling that confident on Nomad 1 anyway. Miss from Eppletopper there, though, as well. And it's later than the one from Kuba, so that's going to be an advantage to Kuba.
Seems more comfortable on this pick, though, than the other maps.
Definitely. I mean, this is obviously kind of just like a hard platter, if you will. And the Kuba X actually finding a miss there, that could flip things over now. Yeah, it's going to flip things over. The lead is now on Eppletopper's side.
Let's go.
Oh, but he finds a miss there. That's really unfortunate. That's going to flip right back over to the Kuba. Oh, and now the Kuba building up combo again. But so is Eppletopper. Oh, it's actually close. This one's closer.
It's very close. Eppletopper has the better accuracy, though.
Oh, yes. Quite a lot, actually.
Oh, no.
There's another miss. That's not going to help him at all. Now they have the same accuracy.
Combo.
Yeah, as long as Kuba X holds combo here, it's going to stay in his lead. As Eppletopper finds another miss there, that's such an unfortunate one. It's that all looking like... Yeah, it's all looking just like simple accidents, you know? Unfortunate. as long as the Kuba X holds combo, then Appletofer has really no way of taking the lead again. We're going to have to hope for a miss from the Kuba X, or Appletofer's going to have to hope for that at least. But he is the one to miss instead.
The Kuba X needs a cat to jump on the skateboard right about now. That would be perfect.
But he actually found two misses there in a row. Appletofer not with big enough combo to capitalize on it just yet. Oh, especially as he misses there. Yeah, it's... Oh, but the Kuba X misses right there before the break. It is still not over, you know. It is still not over.
It's not over. It's a small lead in combo.
If Appletofer is able to hold combo here and get some more misses from Kuba, never know what could happen. Oh, it's close. 60,000 point difference here. All Apple has to do here is just hold and hope for misses. I mean, surely this cannot help for Kuba's nerves here, seeing that it's actually in range of him losing a point. Now, last quarter of the map here. I'm finding it hard to speak. I don't want to bother
these
guys. It's Kuba X misses.
Oh my god.
I'm not sure if that's... No, no, Appletofer phones a miss as well.
I was about to take over the lead too. Oh my god, it was so close.
I think it could have been possible. I actually think with the combo that Appletofer had and with that reset from the Kuba, it could have potentially flipped things over, but...
I think it would have.
One miss at the end, and that another one right before the end there. It's gonna cost him the match here. There was hope, there were openings, but no entrance.
Oh man, that was a good map.
That was a strong pick from Appletofer. You could see there was chances, there were hopes, and I mean, for a ranked 9,000 player, what a great performance. I mean, not even being biased here as an Icelandic player. Yeah, even look at the Kuba X saying, you are not 9.2k, bro, you play well, too good.
Yeah.
That's sportsmanship right there. And congratulations to the Kuba X for playing really well throughout the whole match. I mean,
love to see the sportsmanship. Yeah, such a great match.
Definitely.
There were a couple of maps where Appletofer could have potentially won.
Indeed,
it's always
indeed.
Good to see.
Indeed. I mean, then there was some maps that the Kuba X just did too well on, like Hidden 2 with the FC, so...
And it's hard
overall,
to beat.
It is. Just overall, very good performance from the Kuba X, and I mean, relatively really good performance from Appletofer. That's not a rank 9k player, I'm just going to say.
No, I found myself speechless of, like, in amazement from it. That was so intense. It was so good to watch.
Yes,
and Appletofer's spinners, honestly, you got to play more catch the beat, man. You can be get a lot of global firsts after a couple of years.
Get him to top 5k to play for CWC for us, guys, please. Anyway,
yeah.
There you have it. There's the winner, the Kuba X. He's going to be moving on to the round of 16, the winner's bracket. Appletofer will be going down to the loser's bracket, but he will be facing someone who will lose their first round of 16 match. So he could potentially be facing someone in a similar seed again. However, the Kuba X will be moving on. That's our winner for today.
Who will the Kuba X face next week?
I think it could be Hypno Spirit. I have the bracket right here on my screen. Yeah, it'll be Hypno Spirit. So the Kuba X will be going against Hypno Spirit. And then Appletofer will be going up against the loser of an Apple 7 in the winner's bracket and the winner of Tuka's versus Tracy Sketch in this round. So yeah, it's kind of complicated. But anyway, we'll get to that when it comes to it. Thank you guys for watching. I've been Ash Ketchum, and I've been joined by 1794766 or Jurgen.
Yeah, that was fun. Thanks for having me again.
It was fun. See you guys later tomorrow for the next match.